Make sure to subscribe and hit the like button.
People who are always pushing happiness as the key measure for successful existence, it's so ill-informed that it's embarrassing that that even happens. Positive emotion makes people impulsive. Maniacs, for example, which is really, that's mania, right? Bipolar disorder. If you're manic, you're one happy person. Way too happy. Everything is great. Nothing but wonderful things that are beyond your imagination are going to happen to you, and they're going to happen fast. And so you're down to the mall to buy everything you can possibly get your hands on because you have 100 uses for everything. And then a week later, you know, you crash into your depressive episode and you realize that you're $150,000 in debt and you've alienated everyone that you know. It's like, that's untrammeled positive emotion. So how about no? A peer index of positive emotion is no way of determining whether or not a system is working properly, even your own system. You need a balance between positive and negative emotions. Plus, positive emotions are absolutely exhausting, because if you're in a manic episode, it's like, it's time to get everything good right now. Fine, but you won't sleep for a week, and then you die, because you just burned yourself to a crisp. And so to be overwhelmingly enthusiastic about everything sounds like a real blast, and I've seen full-blown manics and they're having plenty of fun, but it is not a pleasant thing to behold. They're just all over the place, and you know, yeah, it's really not good. You need a balance between these two systems, because the whole world isn't explored territory bursting with nothing but promise. That's not the world. The world is that, in a bounded space, a little bit, with an absolute horror show going out around the periphery. And both systems need to be active in order to keep you balanced. People do, unfortunately, sustain damage sometimes to the left prefrontal cortex, responsible for positive emotion, or the right prefrontal cortex, responsible for negative emotion. And if you sustain right hemisphere prefrontal damage, it makes you inappropriately happy and impulsive, and your life just goes, you just spiral downhill, because you make nothing but impulsive decisions, and you know what the real world consequence of that is, you know? Get drunk and be impulsive for one night, you can learn what the bloody consequences of that are. You try living like that for a month, independently of IQ. That's the other thing that's so interesting. You can blow out your left prefrontal cortex and not suffer much of a decrease, especially in crystallized intelligence. But the fact that you're running on nothing but, sorry, your right hemisphere, you're running on nothing but positive emotion is going to auger you right into the ground. And then if you're perhaps even more unlucky and you lose the left prefrontal cortex, then you're permanently depressed, because there's nothing but the unexplored manifesting itself. We know that if you take depressed people and you do EEG analysis, that they have predominant resting right hemisphere EEG activation. And so that's roughly, so why is this? Well, unknown territory, known territory. You think, well, is that real? Well, it's real enough, so that's how your brain evolved. That seems pretty damn real.